Students, let's continue chapter integers. Now we are going to discuss first subtraction on integers. So properties of subtraction on integers is, first is closure property. If a and b are integers, then a minus b is also an integer. Means the difference of two integers is always integer. For example, a is 1 and b is minus 2. Both are integers. Now let's see a minus b. A minus b is 1 minus 2. It is 1 plus 2. It comes 3. So 3 is also an integer. So difference of two integers is also an integer. Now if a is any integer, then a minus 0 is equal to a. Means suppose minus 5 is an integer. For example, a is equal to minus 5 and minus 5 is an integer. So minus 5 minus 0 is equal to what? It is equal to minus 5 only. So if a is any integer, the difference of a and 0 is a number itself. The difference of a and 0 is the number itself. The difference of minus 5 and 0 is minus 5. Next, discuss sums from your textbook. Subtract the sum of minus 158 and 830. Let's discuss this. Sum of minus 50 and 830. So what we want to do, subtract the sum. First we will find out the sum of this. Sum of, in case 1, what we will do, we will first find out the sum of. So when we will find, now we see, there are opposite sign. When we have two opposite sign, we subtract the terms. What we do, we subtract the term. So let's subtract the term. So when we subtract the term, here comes 237. And sign of bigger term comes. Sign of bigger term is minus. So first we have done the sum of minus 1050 and 813. So what is the answer of this? It is minus 237. Now next. Now read the statement like this. Subtract the minus 237 from minus 23. Now we want to subtract in part 2. In case 2, what we want to do? We want to do subtract minus 237 from 23. Subtract minus 237 from minus 23. So from terms comes first. Keep it in bracket. So here we know that there is only single sign between two terms. So there are two signs. First convert this into single sign. Minus minus plus. So again we have two opposite signs. We will subtract the terms. So when we subtract the terms, what we get? So here we get 240. And sign of bigger term comes. I hope it is clear to you. Next, simplify this. First simplify this, then simplify the second bracket, and then find out their sum. Let's simplify first this. Minus 13, minus minus it is, plus. It remain as it is. Again, minus 22, minus minus it is, plus. So we have two opposite signs. We will subtract the terms. 17 minus 13 it is, 4. Sign of bigger term comes. Next, again we have two opposite signs. We will subtract the term. So let's subtract 40 and 22. What comes here? 18. 18 of which sign? Positive sign. So plus 4 plus 18. So it is 22. After simplify both the terms, we get 22. Look at the third sum. The sum of two integers is 65. What is given? Sum of two integers. If one of the integer is minus 47. So we have one integer is minus 47. Find the other. So what is other? We don't know other. Let other be 1. And the sum of these two integers is minus 60. Sorry, plus 65. 2 integer is 65. No sign is there, it means it is positive. So let the other integer be, other integers be 1. So y remain here only, 65 remain here. So which we will take this minus 47 from left hand side to right hand side, and when the term moves from left hand side to right hand side, its sign changes. If it is minus, it becomes plus. If it is plus, it becomes minus. Now y is equal to 65 plus 47. So here it is, come, just add, because both the terms have positive sign, so we'll just add the terms. 65 plus 47, it is 112. So other integer is 112. So these sums I have taken from your subtraction on integers textbook. Thank you.